been having dreams. Tripping, I'm falling in love. What is good, YouTube? I am here to let y'all know if you guys want to get some early tips and tricks on how to, you know, do a certain dribble move or get right with a play, how to play defense, play lanes, you know what I'm saying, stuff like that, wall up animations, post moves, drag backs, anything you're trying to think of, you know, different sets, different defensive settings, things like that, go ahead and check out my boy RCA's Patreon, man. He definitely can cover anything that you need, and I'm also there too. If you have any questions, stuff like that, go ahead, check it out, man. Links right there in the description. Hello everyone, how are you doing today? Now look, check it out, man. This is a post tutorial on Dirk, man, you feel me? And I feel like, you know, I made a post tutorial, so you know, I'm not gonna go over every little thing now, but I am gonna show you guys what makes Dirk super elite when it comes to scoring in the post, you feel me? And I'm gonna, you know, obviously show like his best moves and stuff like that with his little one-legger and things, dribbling out his one-legger, you know, having his quick fade and then doing an up and under afterwards. Like, those are what makes, you know, Dirk special. Cause look, you have to jump on this. You have to jump on this. So eventually, when a person is, you know, when they're getting sick of you doing this, you know, it's time to hit it up and under, you feel me? But look, check it out. First things we're gonna work on is Dirk's one-legged fade. And all you have to do to do that is it's always to the right. It's always to the left. Because the one on the right is technically not a one-legger, but it still creates a lot of space. All you gotta do is hold down on the right analog stick while you're running. And you can dribble out of it. Always remember that. You can dribble out of it, okay? So when you trigger the animation to dribble out of it, you just let go. Immediately when you see the animation, you let go and then you can complete your dribble. Right when you see Dirk did a step back, you just start moving again. But to do the one-legger, you hold down on the right analog stick while you are running, all right? OP move, trust, OP move, never contested. Just had to get that one out of the way. Now look, you know where I like to spot up at, you know, left side of the court, you know, inside the post, you feel me? Now here's the thing. When you're posted up, you're holding L2, right? And you want to use the left analog stick to fade the opposite way. Not left, my fault. The right analog stick to fade the opposite way, all right? Now, here's the thing with this, why it makes it so OP. Obviously, you're turning real quick and you're shooting the post fade. So, it's really quick. You know, it's not something slow. Like, a lot of post fades be slow and stuff like that. But here's the thing. You can be moving over. And then the minute, you know, you just stop and just instantly shimmy back that way while you move, fade the other way. Best fade to me personally, best fade, post fade in the game. There's a lot of good post fades in the game too though, but to me personally, that is the best post fade in the game. And all it is is with the right stick. You know, you're just holding the right stick the opposite direction that you are going. Obviously I'm gonna it on the screen to let you know which way to point the right analog stick. You're gonna create super space. Now look, now you're sitting here killing your opponent with that all game now, right? So he's gonna end up jumping eventually, so I'm gonna need you guys to get this up and under down, all right? Now when it comes to the up and under, all you have to do is activate the move and let go, all right? So the minute you see Dirk start doing his fade, you stop right there, and then you can do the up and under. But look, you wanna continue it, all right? You stop, let go, then continue it right afterwards. So it's a quick 1-2. Come here this way, back that way, you feel me? Just like that, all right? You're holding L2. You're holding L2 the whole time. One move, and then you let go, just like that. Remember, always let go the minute you see the animation starting. You let go, and then you go right back to the right stick to continue it, all right? Because if you're in the post and you let go, right, it's gonna go straight into a standing shot if you let go and don't continue it. So it's real quick, let go, then right back into it, just like that for the up and under. And obviously if you wanna up and under for the layups, you gotta be directly under the rim. Well, I would say like you have to be in the paint. You have to be in the paint to get the layup animations for the up and unders. But outside the paint, it's a 1-2 just like that. But you have to time that one. If you're outside the paint and you're doing the up and under, you have to time it. So it's a jump shot timing. Just like that. These are the most OPS things when it comes to Dirk. Doing his one-legged step back, dribbling out of it, doing his post fade, going to, you know, you're moving to the right, and then boom, quickly go to the left, stuff like that. And then his up and under out of it. 1-2 just like that. That's all I have for you guys today, man. These are the most OPS things when it comes to using Dirk and why he is the best center in the game. Now look, there's some tough centers in the game now. You know, you got Yao Ming, you got Dirk, you got D-Rob, which is very, very good. But when it comes to really dropping somebody off, really being a nuisance and a problem, and Jokic, you got to bring up Jokic in the conversation. Dirk is a problem. Y'all know how fast his jump shot is. You know how things go when it comes to using Dirk in the post, y'all. But look, man, it's been your boy July Glow, man. If you're new here, like, comment, subscribe. We're on the road to 1K, man. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Y'all stay blessed.